that you mute your microphone, which I believe they all are anyways, and unshare your video button so you're not visible on the screen, which seems to be the case. So if you're comfortable with that, after the presentation that Elizabeth does, there will be a question and answer period, and you can share your image and unmute your mic if you'd like to ask a question. By doing so, you're giving permission to PEL Ottawa to be viewed and recorded. Also, please ensure that your cell phones are muted during the entire session, particularly during the Q&A session. PEL Ottawa would like to acknowledge the really generous support of the New Horizons Program, Employment and Social Development Canada, of the Government of Canada, that makes this arts festival possible. For anybody that is new to PEL Ottawa or doesn't have any knowledge of the organization, PEL Ottawa provides arts workers aged 55 and over with affordable housing and health and social supports in a very caring and creative community. And this certainly keeps us busy and requires us to be, you know, really current in terms of the needs of our constituency. I would really encourage you all to visit our website, which is www.palottawa.org, for more information. The arts festival that is being launched today is a really great opportunity to support those arts workers presenting who are living at or below the poverty line. It's really, really hard to be, and always has been hard to be, an arts worker. At the same time, the arts workers that you will see over the next 2 months during the course of the festival seek to provide entertainment, education, and enlightenment to our community who are so greatly impacted by this horrible COVID pandemic. Hopefully, such as initiatives like this festival will encourage people of all ages, not necessarily 55 and over, to join PAL, become a member, donate, and help us carry out our important mission. And now, a brief introduction of today's artist, Elizabeth Emond-Stevenson. Elizabeth Emond-Stevenson is a Franco-Ontarian dance artist from the traditional unceded territory of the Algonquin Anishnawbe people. Under the name Take Up Space, Elizabeth creates, performs, collaborates through connections between people, places, art forms, from an inclusive feminist perspective that aims to create space for collaborators and audiences alike. Elizabeth's work has been supported through platforms such as Tactics, Theater 4669, Dark Horse Dance Projects, the National Arts Centre, Canada Performs, the Uproar Festival, and many more. She's had the pleasure of dancing for Alison Burns, Lois Chan, Cor Barra Dance Theatre, Kaya Irwin, and other well-known artists and organizations. Her community practice includes creating, facilitating movement workshops with Amethyst Women's Addiction Centre, teaching for the City of Ottawa's I Love to Dance program, and a recent commission by the City of Ottawa's Public Art Program. Through Take Up Space, Elizabeth currently co-facilitates Conversations, a discussion series for and by the Ottawa Gatineau dance community. And along with Ottawa Dance Directive, she spearheaded Half In, Half Out, a series of indoor and outdoor dance classes in response to the community's need for training during the COVID pandemic. This past fall, Elizabeth attended the Banff Center for the Arts first line offering Creative Practice for Temporary Dance. Elizabeth is a company member of Tara Lou's Dance and educator, rehearsal coach, and guest artist with Propeller Dance. And now, without any further delay, please give a warm round of applause, even though your mics are off, for Elizabeth Emond-Stevenson, as she kicks off PEL Ottawa's Online Arts Festival Spotlight 2021.
Thank you very much, David. It's so nice to have you all joining me today here for this workshop. Bonjour tout le monde. Merci d'être venu à l'atelier. So this workshop is called ABCs in Action, and it will give you a taste of how to start developing your own personal movement vocabulary in a way that is accessible to us in our small spaces and sort of altered ways of being because of the pandemic. I'd like us all to start by making sure that the space around you is clear, whatever amount of space that is, so that you won't be colliding into things, making sure that there's nothing on your floor, just ensuring that you have a safe space to move in for yourself today. And we're gonna start this workshop with some breathing exercises. I'd like us to start by placing a hand on our chest, if that's accessible to you. And we're just gonna start with three deep breaths with our hand on our chest, feeling the chest rise and lower with each breath. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling and exhaling. We're gonna move our breath and our attention now to our core and our stomach. So I invite you to also move your hands down to your stomach if that's accessible to you today. And again, we're gonna take three deep breaths from our stomach, breathing in and out. On expire, on expire. Last time, breathing in. Breathing out. And because our breathing is actually not just taking place in a frontal space, we're gonna place our hands on our back and we're gonna take three deep breaths, feeling our rib cage and our back expand. I'll turn around to demonstrate here. Breathing in and breathing out. Inspire. Expire. Last time, dernière fois, breathing in, breathing out. Continuing on with this idea, we're going to use our breath to move different parts of our body in space. So very simply, we're going to start with a hand. You're going to lift your hand up, and when you breathe in, the air and the breath is gonna move your hand. And when you breathe out, the air is gonna move your hand the other way. Breathing in, move your hand one way. Breathing out, move your hand the other way. One more time with your hand. Breathing in, feeling the hand move. Breathing out, feeling the hand move back. We're gonna try the same idea now using our head. So you can move your head forward and back. You can move your head side to side. You can choose which direction your head moves when you breathe in and breathe out. So we'll do that three times together. Breathing in, move your head. Breathing out, your head moves away. Breathing in, moving the head. Breathing out, head changes direction. Breathing in, head moves. Breathing out, head moves the other way. We're gonna continue on with this idea, and we're gonna try this idea with both arms. So the breath is gonna move our arms, and the exhale is gonna move our arms in another direction. Breathing in, arms move. Breathing out, arms change direction. Breathing in, arms move. Breathing out, on expire, les bras changent de direction. Good. We're gonna experiment with this idea in space. So if we were to choose, for example, our chest, everyone give your chest a little rub, bringing some attention to our chest. Our chest is going to move with the inhale and exhale, and that's gonna take us through our space. Breathing in, The chest is reaching forward. This can move you perhaps towards your screen. Breathing out. The chest moves us away from the screen. Let's do that again. Breathing in. The chest moves us towards your screen. And breathing out. The chest moves us away. One more time. Breathing in. The chest opens us towards the screen. And breathing out. The chest moves us away. We're going to try this. We're going to return back to our arms. Breathing in and out, our arms are going to take us through space. This is a free form exploration. So that means there's no right or wrong. You're going to breathe in, moving your arm through space, and breathe out, changing direction. Breathing in, moving through space, your arm is moving you through space. Breathing out, changing direction. One more time with both arms. Breathing in, the arms move you through space. And breathing out, changing direction. I'm going to call on different body parts that we've explored, and you're simply going to move through space with those body parts in your own time, breathing in and out. Let's try using our pelvis. So we're going to use our pelvis, breathing in and out, to move through space. Let's start with small movements of the pelvis. Breathing in as you circle your pelvis one way. Breathe out, circle the other way. Let's try that again. Breathing in, circling the pelvis one way. Breathing out, circling the pelvis the other way. Good. We're going to let this do become a little bit of a dance, traveling through space. So while you travel through space, you're going to move your pelvis in whatever way feels comfortable to you while you breathe in and out. Breathing in, breathing out. Pelvis is moving. It doesn't have to look any particular way. Breathing in and breathing out. Last time, breathing in, breathing out. We're going to take this into the whole body. Your whole body is going to respond to your breath, however feels comfortable and accessible to you today in this moment. Taking deep breaths in and out, let your body move the way it wants to move through space. Breathing in and breathing out. Breathing in and breathing out. Breathing in and breathing out. I'm going to count up to eight, and we're going to take our pace slightly faster as I get from one to eight. Here we go. One, two, getting a little bit spicier. Three, four, a little bit faster. Five, breathing and moving. Six, seven, getting faster to your limit. And eight, we're going to go the other way, counting from eight to one, getting from fast to slow. Here we go. Eight, seven, a little gentler. Six, five, slowing down. Four, three, and two, finding stillness for yourself. And one, take a moment to return to the breath in your chest and your stomach. And feel your feet or your pelvis grounded in the floor or in the chair, wherever you are.
be a long session.
Good, everyone. Let's keep going. I'm just going to check in. Good. Okay. The next thing we're going to explore together is a twisting, folding, circling, pushing exercise. I'll show you what I mean by that, and then we'll try it together. We're gonna start in a star shape. So my arms are reaching long and my legs are reaching long beneath me, either standing or sitting in a chair. We're going to fold our body to one side, twisting. The word is twisting. We twist our body one way and we untwist, come back to your star. We twist our body the other way and we untwist. Then we're gonna fold our body forward to whatever point is comfortable and accessible to you, folding your body forward, then you come back up, come back up, come back up. We repeat that all again. So we twist our body, we untwist our body. Other side, twist our body, untwist our body. We fold en pli, and you come back, on retourne à l'étoile. From here, we're gonna circle our arms back in space, circling and circling. Now we're going to push forward as if there was something very heavy in front of us. Push and push, circling the other way. Déceptre bras dans l'autre sens, circling and circling and pushing and pushing. I'm gonna show that one more time from the beginning. You're welcome to join me in practicing. And then I'll put on some music for us in the background to move to. So we start in a star, our limbs are extended, that's great. We're going to twist our body, untwist. Twist our body, untwist. We fold, we return to our star. Again, we twist, untwist, good, twist, untwist, and we fold our body forward, coming back to our star, circling back with our arms, twice. We push, en pousse, we push, other way, forward circle. And forward circle, and push, all right, everyone, let's try this with a bit of music in the background to get us moving. Just give me one sec to get that set up here. All right. Find your star shape. Let's do this together. Here we go. We're going to twist.
You are the
and
sunshine
untwist.
Of my life.
Twist. Untwist. Folding your body.
That's why I'll always be around.
And unfold. Reaching long. Do that again.
Circle.
Circle. Way. So the same way we explored big movement, we're going to go in the opposite direction and see what it's like to twist our body as small as we can. Twist our body as small as we can. Fold our body as small as we can. Then we're going to go back to the big to see if we can feel the differences. Let's try that. Finding your star shape for micro twisting, circling, pushing, folding.
Why I'll always stay around.
Micro, small, twist.
You are the apple of my eye. Forever you stay the one.
Now we're going to do our circles. So these circles could just be with shoulders, small and small. Little push.
Let's get this party started.
Little
go ahead
push.
And make an equal sign with those forearms and meet me in a plank. We're gonna rotate.
And forward, little push, good. Let's go back to the big and feel the difference, feel our whole body working together. I'm gonna get our music back on for that. Here we go. All right, finding our star, huge whole body. We fold, come back.
That's why I'll always
and all the way to your star. Once again, whole body engage. Pull, twist, I should say, untwist. And twist. Untwist. Folding here. Coming back. We're going to circle. Big full body engagement.
I feel like this is the biggest thing.
Circling. Now you're pushing.
So I love
excellent. Let's keep building. The next thing we're going to do together is we're going to create straight lines with our body. We're going to create circles with our body. And we're going to create figure eights with our body. So I'm going to lead us through a follow along isolation where we're going to work on these straight lines. We're going to work on these circles. We're going to work on these figure eights in space together. Let me get that music set up here. Once again, make sure you have enough space. I would suggest starting in the center of your space for this. All right. Here we go. Straight line starting with the head. Head is tilting side to side.
Now, where have you been? You know that I've been waiting for you.
See what you see, what
hey
you
now, see. What have you seen? You know that I've been looking
head
for
down,
you.
Head, yes.
My electric field, my sound field,
the
electric
down.
Water.
Shoulders are moving up and down.
If tidal sound,
I'm just gonna check the track.
My electric field, my sound field.
Good. Keep going up and down.
Electric water.
The muscles and the bones working together. We're going to
down
the elbows.
Feel
now.
Me on the sand.
So elbows are.
You know that I've been waiting for you.
Good. In our body, it might look like this. It might be a side to side figure eight. It could also be, this is a bit of a trickier one, a front and back figure eight. Let's explore a side to side figure eight together. One side, other side. One side, other side. Like I said, this is a tricky shape in the body, but it's good to practice feeling the beginnings of that shape. Okay, from here, we're going to take our straight lines, our circles, and our figure eights, and we're going to take them through space at different levels. So the first level we're going to explore is the level we've been on right now. So we can call this level the medium level. We're going to move through our space with straight lines, however those straight lines appear in your body today. You could simply take the moves that we did earlier and you could just walk or travel them through space. Or if you'd like, you could get creative and create your own straight line shapes while moving through space. So that's how we're gonna start. Then I'm going to call out circles. For circles, we're going to use the high level. So this space up here is the space we're going to explore with circles. You can use your arm to explore that. You can lift your head. Basically, the high level is anything higher than this medium level. So you don't have to jump. You can if you wish, but we're exploring the high level with circles of the body. And once again, you can take the circles that we did, circling the head or the shoulders or the wrists, or you can make your own circles. The next thing I'm going to call out is figure eights, and figure eights are going to be a low level. I'm just going to adjust my camera to demonstrate that. So the low level is anything below our medium level. You could choose to simply trace figure eights with your finger on your floor space like we did. You could choose to trace a figure eight with your foot on the floor. You could choose to sit on the floor and make figure eights with your arms. Up to you. Let's try this with a little bit of music in the background. Our straight lines, our circles, and our figure eights at medium, high, and low levels. Here we go. Just something atmospheric for us to have in the background here. All right, starting with our straight lines at a median level. Here you go. I'm gonna give you some options. Feel free to take inspiration from what I do or create your own straight lines. Straight lines in space. Once again, you can always return to the straight lines that we did together earlier. Walking can be a straight line. All right, nice. Let's move on to circles at a high level. Finding circles in your body at a high level. I'm using a lot of arms because arms are a very accessible way to reach for that high level. You can also use your head. You can also do a little jump if that's accessible to you. Finding circles in this high level. Once again, you can always return to the circles we did together. You can create a circle in your space by traveling. Beautiful. Now we're going to move to our figure eights on a low level. As I explained earlier, you can just trace a figure eight on your floor space with your hand. You can use one leg to trace a figure eight. You could sit down on the ground if you wish, if that's accessible to you. You could just bend down. All the options are possible. Figure eights at a low level. Right. We're going to find ourselves back in the center of our space in 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice work, everyone. It's funny not being able to see you, most of you, but I can feel your presence, and it's nice to be dancing with such a big group. From here, we're going to continue on in our exercises in our workshop, And we're sort of building upon the concepts that we've been exploring together. The next thing I'd like us to do is we're going to create a signature movement sequence using the ideas that we've built together. And in order to do that, we're gonna get a little bit silly. We're gonna start by writing our names with a finger. So take a moment for yourself and simply write your name in the air with a finger. If you don't want to write your name, write your pet's name, write the name you've always wished you had. Donc, on écrit nos noms avec nos doigts. Good. We have that established there. Excellent. Now, the same way we explored different body parts before, we're going to do that with our names. So you're going to write your name as if your head was a giant marker. Your head is going to write your name. Go ahead and give that a try for yourself. So because my name's Elizabeth, it's quite a long name. It's going to take me a little bit of time to finish, but that's okay. On écrit nos noms avec la tête. I'll give everyone a moment to finish that up there. Good. Now we're going to try with an elbow. Pick an elbow. We're going to trace our name with our elbow. This can, if your name is long, it might take you in a circle if that fits best in your space. Nice, everybody. And lastly, we're going to write with the hip. So this for different people can look very small or bigger depending on your range of movement and your space and how you're feeling today. So go ahead and give that a try. Pick one hip to write your name out in space. Okay. From here, if you're bored with your name, pick another word, but we're going to keep going with this writing idea. And we're going to pretend that we're either experienced graphic designers or calligraphers, and we're going to see what it's like in space to write our name or another word of your choosing in really big block letters, as if there was a huge sign outside with your name on it. I want you to see how you can fill the space with your name. So this is juicy, big, beautiful lettering of your name made with your body. Just give that a try for yourself. This is going to probably take you farther in space than your previous exploration. Think about how we've engaged different body parts and try to let those body parts become a part of your lettering. You might use a knee. You might use a rib. You might use an eye even. Nice. Good work, everyone. Now I'd like to see how this differs from us writing our names in tiny, spidery handwriting. On top of that, we're gonna add, you're going to trace your name backwards now. So we're going from the last letter of your name all the way to the first letter of your name, but we're doing it in tiny, spidery handwriting. Donc l'écriture à la main, très, très petite. Here we go. From the last letter to the first letter, tiny little spidery writing. What is that like in your body? Maybe this is somewhat the way you already write. Maybe it's very different from the way you do. Maybe you don't handwrite anymore. I'm not sure. Good. The last one I'd like us to explore is very no-nonsense Times New Roman font. what is that like in the naming of your word in your body? And we're gonna continue going from backwards to forwards just for something fresh. So Times New Roman font, what does that feel like, look like? How does that travel in your body today? Good, everyone. Excellent. This is the part where we create our own signature movement sequence. So we've explored breathing into different body parts. We've explored twisting, folding, circling, pushing. We've explored straight lines, circles, figure eights. We've explored levels. And we're going to put all this together into one sequence that can serve as a representation of your own personal style through movement. We're gonna pick one action. So you are going to pick one action. Donc on va chacun choisir une action. And the actions are twist or fold or circle or push. So take a moment for yourself. I'll write these in the chat. You're gonna pick twist or fold or circle or what was my last one? Push. Pick one of those four for yourself. Okay, then we're going to each pick a direction. And the choices that I'm going to offer to you are forward and back is one direction, side to side is another direction. And we're gonna say that on the spot is a third direction. On a trois choix pour les directions, soit devant, derrière, de côté à côté, ou sur place. So I'm gonna write those in here as well. So you've got forward and back, and you'll pick one of these, or on the spot, or side to side. Choose one of those three. And then we're gonna pick a speed. So we explore doing things slower and faster. The speeds are just gonna be slow or fast. Donc, soit lent ou vite. Slow or fast, pick that for yourself. And our last choice, is this right? Dun, 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 dun. Yes, okay. Our last choice is one level. So our levels are low, medium or high. So you're going to pick one of those for yourself. From here, we're going to incorporate these into the spelling of our names. So for each thing that you picked, your action, your direction, your level, and your speed, you're going to pick one letter of your name to apply those to. For example, the first letter of my name is E. I'm gonna choose to twist during my E. So I'm gonna twist my body for my E. And then say, I skip over L, say the next letter I work with is I, and say that my direction for I is side to side. So I make my I travel side to side. Say the next letter I work with in my name is Z. For my Z, I'm going to pick a speed and I'm going to pick slow. So I'm going to very slowly trace my Z. And then say the next letter I choose to work with is the H in my name. For the H, I'm going to do my level and I'm going to pick a high level. So for my H, I'm going to jump my H high. So I want you to each take a minute to work with those elements in your name. So I'll repeat it again. You're gonna add one action, which is twist, fold, circle, or push. So pick one letter in your name to either twist, fold, circle, or push. Then you're going to pick a direction for another letter in your name, forward and back, side to side, or on the spot. Pick another letter in your name to change the level from low, medium, or high, and pick a fourth letter in your name to change the speed, either slow or fast. Take a minute to get that in your body, and then we're gonna put on some music and we're gonna try doing this, our letterings, all together. If you have questions or you need help, feel free to turn your mic on and I can assist you that way. Good, everyone. I'll give you another minute to get it in your body and feel comfortable with it. If you have it already, go through it once more in your body so that you can enjoy the music while we play it and dance to it. All right, let's give it a try with some music. See how the music influences your movement. We're just wanting to have fun with this and explore creative ways of moving. Donc, on y va avec un peu de musique ensemble. Here we go.
Makes no difference if it's sweet or hot. Give that rhythm everything you've got. Oh, don't mean a thing if you ain't got that swing. Do I, 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 do I,
all right. I'd like us to make sure that we're properly cooled down and stretched before we leave the workshop and head to the question and answer period. So I'm just going to bring us back to our breathing once more. I invite you to put a hand again on your chest and a hand on your stomach, and we're going to take three breaths together, feeling our chest and our stomach expanding.
On va retourner à la respiration, des inspirations et des expirations avec une main sur la poitrine et une main sur l'estomac.
Here we go, breathing in and out. In your own time, breathing in and out. Last time, breathing in and out. I'm going to lead us through some stretches. Feel free to modify or abstain from the stretches if they're not suitable to your body. I'm going to take one arm across my body and hold that arm in place with the other arm, and I'm going to hold for four, three, two, and one, and let it go. I'm gonna switch arms, crossing one arm in front of my body, breathing and holding for four, three, two, and one, letting that go. I'm going to return to this push that we did. I'm gonna push forward. I'm curving my back a little bit, and I'm gonna open and let it drop. I'm gonna push, feeling the push and the tension. I'm gonna open and I'm gonna release. One more time. Push, feel your spine curve. Open, feel yourself expand and let it go. I'm going to invite you to take a calf stretch if that's accessible to you. So you can use a surface such as a table or a wall or just free stand. I'm gonna bend my front leg and keep my back leg straight so that I'm stretching the calf of the leg in the back. I'm gonna hold this for four, three, two, and one. Gently, I'm gonna bring that leg back and I'm gonna step the other leg back. Donc, étirement de la cuisse, ou du mollet, je m'excuse. And holding for quatre, trois, deux, et un. Good, everybody. For the last 3 minutes, I'm gonna put on kind of a cheesy but fun song so that we can do a little bit of a dance party together. So you can move however you'd like, just responding to the music, using it as a way to let go of any tensions you might have built up in your body. Here's the song we're gonna listen to.
Thank you.
that concludes the workshop portion of today. Thank you everyone for your wonderful movement and dancing. Even though I couldn't see it, it was great to dance with you. Merci à tout le monde. Merci d'être venu à ABC in Action. J'apprécie beaucoup votre énergie. Je sais que c'est un peu différent quand on ne peut pas se voir, mais c'est quand même une très belle expérience.
Thank you so much, Elizabeth. I never realized that dancing is so difficult. I mean, it's something I've always known, but you know, that exercise of picking you know, circles or squares or straight ahead and the speed and other things, it's almost like playing 5-6 dimensional chess. So it's really challenging both from you know, a body, your body physical point of view, but also mentally. It's just amazing. I'd like to open it up for, you know, 5-10 minutes to the audience as to any questions that they might have of Elizabeth. So I'll just open it up. If you'd like to ask a question, you can obviously unmute your mic. And if you want to be visible, that would be great as well. Any questions for Elizabeth? Anne? Anne's got a question.
Hi, Elizabeth. That was really fun and so energetic, and I can't dance, but oh my goodness, that was really great. The question is, when you are dancing, when you're learning a routine, there's obviously a lot of body memory, but do you have like a shorthand that you use to make notes so that you know where you're going? Like how do you compose and remember?
Your shorthand is going to be different. I find that describing different aspects of what I'm doing helps me. So if I'm going to write down a dance I made, I'll say, if this is the move, let's say this is the move, if I'm circling and turning back, I would write.
Can't hear you, Elizabeth.
Can you hear me now?
No.
Can you hear me now?
I can't hear you either.
No, can't hear you.
What about now?
Nope.
Gone.
No.
One minute.